Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 94 of the Realm Recap. I am Jason from YakFace.com, joined as always by FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net.
I feel 94. I think every show we do makes me feel how old I am these days, especially with as you're sharing on your screen, which is a royal purple shame.
Oh, I know. There we go. Big bummer.
Oh, it is a bummer.
A few bits to talk about this week. A little bit of Hasbro stuff, Funko stuff. Funko's got a bunch of stuff, actually. Some Gentle Giant and Sideshow news, but we'll start off the week, as we always do, with the Hasbro portion of the show. A few bits of, you know, announcements and rumors have been sprinkled about. Our friends at Jedi News had posted a few rumors this week, kind of not necessarily confirming, but speculation regarding the first three waves of the Black Series 6-inch line that's going to be hitting stores for Force Friday, which is September 30th here in the U.S., all geared around Rogue One. So
these look fantastic. I've just literally just had a chance to look through them. I hadn't seen them until you posted them. So, yeah, Rey, BB-8 repack, Kylo Ren, a new mold. Could that be the one with no helmet? I don't know.
That'd be worth it, I think.
I think so too. Jyn Erso, Stormtrooper, medical droid, Rogue One, SEAL team male, potentially Forrest Whitaker's character.
Hmm.
And the other ones they posted, Leia, finally getting the New Hope Leia.
Right.
Emperor Command. There's some really good stuff in the looks of this. I mean, again, click the show notes if you want to have a look through it. But I'm just so pumped for the Black Series. I love this line so much. And looks great. That AT-AT driver is rumored as well. Finally, we get a chance to get that. Obi-Wan, that figure has been so long in the making.
What's kind of interesting about that Obi-Wan is they have it listed as an Episode 5 Obi-Wan, which would be a spirit Obi-Wan.
That's true.
kind of different. I, you know, if they're going to do one and it's going to be a spirit, you know, they might as well do the spirit one first, because they could always re-release the mold as a non-dead guy version.
Yeah, that'd be a weird one for the Black Series, 6-inch hologram figure. I don't know whether that would work. I don't know. Certainly, I mean, of all the lists there, there's a nice, there's troopers and humans and all sorts of kind of mixtures, but I don't know what it is with people, but Riven, just, wow, people are going bananas for that figure.
I know, I can't wait to get a hold of it.
I know, but it's a great looking figure, but it's quite an unexciting one in some ways. He doesn't, I don't know. Personal choice. Love to hear your thoughts and comments on the show, people that you're watching. But Darth Revan, is he really, really? Is that what you're really after? But maybe I'm wrong.
Well, with all of the EU and Legends kind of craziness that's gone on this week, I don't know if you got a chance to see that billboard that got posted some people paid for in order to bring back Legends and make that canon again. I don't know if you had got a chance to see that, but that's been a big deal this week. If you just it popped across a lot of social media channels regarding the diehard people that want some of those original stories that were told to be brought back into canon. They paid to have a billboard printed and posted in, you know, I think it's in San Francisco. So,
kind of crazy. You really want Jackson back, Jackson the Rabbit back that bad? It's like you'd pay money to have a...
There's people that love their classic expanded universe stuff that don't like that it's been cast aside.
But I think, I mean, it's, from my point of view and perspective, and you tell me what you think, but it's the Disney model. It's the Marvel model of one connected universe, you know, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Right.
And Captain America, you know, connect the whole thing and make cohesive stories, but you can still have comics that are completely off kilter and, but
in my opinion, in my opinion, it's all fake anyway. So
exactly, it's not real.
Right.
It's not. Speak it up.
Yeah. I don't know. It's tough for me to get worked up over what isn't real and what is less real. You know, I don't know.
I agree.
I'm not discounting anyone's, you know, preference as far as, you know, they love like sure. Some of those classic expanded universe stories, you know, like the Shadows of the Empire and the Thrawn trilogy, all that stuff. You know, those are such, you know, there's such a devoted following to some of those stories. It's tough to pretend that those don't exist anymore. But
sure, that's for sure. It is a little tough. I get that, but
it doesn't mean you can't like them.
No, but the thing is, I mean, Star Wars is probably going to remain long after most of us. It will continue, no doubt. Disney has its ways, so you're not going to be alive anyway, so
right.
Don't worry about it too much. Anyway.
Moving on to some more 6-inch Black Series stuff. The 6-inch Rey figure that's exclusive to Kmart here in the U.S. has started hitting retail. I know that's different reports from across the U.S. has started to show up. I know Dan Hurto, even from our friends over at the First Order Transmissions, he was able to pick one of those up, and he posted some loose and packaged shots over on his Facebook page today. So it's out there, and the Kylo Ren is reshipping, so you can get another chance at that if you missed it before.
That's excellent. That's a good thing to do.
Yeah,
I ordered a couple from Kmart myself. Still haven't received a shipping notification, but
yeah, I have not. Is a little.
You ordered as well?
Yeah. Yep.
A little weird to do that, but never mind. So yeah, I'm dying to get these two connected and get the base and see the pictures, and I'll be on the lookout for that.
Yeah, it looks really good. It's a nice display, and they look well. You know, as a packaged display.
A package duo, dynamic duo. Yes, they will be.
Let's see what else. More 6-inch stuff. The Ahsoka wave. You know, everyone's dying to get that Ahsoka figure. Received a few reports via social media, Twitter especially, that it started to show up at Walgreens. So if you have a Walgreens in your area, you might want to hit those up a little bit harder. I know I've been checking Walgreens quite a bit lately, just for the fact that Funko has had their exclusive pops showing up at Walgreens. So it's just another reason to go into those stores. I mean, even if you don't collect pops, pick them up for people that do. I don't know.
Exactly. Help others. Absolutely. That's right. There's plenty of people looking for these things, as you and I know.
Yeah. But, I found mine, so I'm good. But
look, I was able to get some, and I've got some coming from Dorks, a couple of places as well. So you can get them, but that's, I think, good God, we always do this. When toys come out, people just lose it. They go bananas if they don't get it. And it's just try and be a little bit patient. I've seen a lot of people emailing and asking things. Where are they? Like, they're coming. Hang on. Little Han China are making this quickly as possible and getting them on a boat. So they're coming. Okay.
Let's see. Black Series 3¾-inch. Some boxed images had shown up via social media again of the Phasma, the Han in the Starkiller base gear, as well as the the kind of fancy formal dress Leia that had started showing up in Singapore, I believe. Someone had shared this on Instagram. And we shared that on our front page. So get official confirmation again that these are in the same similar packaging to the Walmart exclusives that are here in the U.S. Again, no numbering on the packaging. So it's definitely still an exclusive wave. So it's just a matter of it getting officially announced or show up at Walmart.
Yet again, or as in the UK, I think that's the other one. But why can't Hasbro tell us about these? Why do we have to scrape to find the news? It's so painful. Anyway,
I know it.
They could use the pulse to tell us, but never mind. So at least we know what's coming. So they look good. I like those. Very good.
Yep. And then some of the 6-inch product has started showing up and shipping from online stores. You had posted a link here for Dorkside.
Yeah, I just noticed they had the Jango Fett, which seems to sell it everywhere I go. It's always one that people are always clamoring to get because it's an awesome figure. Mm-hmm. So if you haven't got one, they're Kanan, also a great figure. Build up a Snowtrooper, there's plenty of them. Luke is another one, which is brand new, $21.99. I mean, I'm seeing people paying every day $40 and $50 for these figures. Why? I don't do it. Just hang in there. You'll get them. There's $22 and you can get the damn thing. But there was that. And the other one that I noticed at the post that I just retweeted this morning was Darth Vader is back in stock. So if you haven't picked that up, the Black Series 6-inch Darth Vader, which I really liked. I thought it was a great figure. A few people had issues with the helmet and so forth. But until they do another one, this was another figure that was going for $40-$50 at one point. But yeah, he's available. So if you missed him, grab him. I think it's a great figure. So
excellent.
He's always one.
Let's see. Moving on from Hasbro to some Funko news this week. Like I mentioned just a bit ago, Walgreens has started receiving some of the exclusive assortment of their Pop figures, their Pop bobbleheads. This was a shot I had taken and shared across Twitter that I had found this week. So,
excellent. They look great. They really do.
I love them. They're fantastic.
And now they're just growing and growing, just the popularity of these things. Go ahead.
I was going to say, sorry. I think Reese, depending on how you pronounce it, is the best of the four. I personally like that one. It's just such a weird choice, you know.
He is, isn't he? He is a weird alien to do, but I think with the blue Snaggletooth that's been released in the Smuggler's Bounty that you shared the last time we talked about it, I know a lot of people who've suddenly paid attention now to the Funko Pop Star Wars line just because of that figure alone. So, yeah.
I mean, if they're going to go as, you know, meta niche as the blue Snaggletooth, they're gonna get to some crazy ones, you know. Maybe they'll do a yak face. Fingers crossed.
Hey.
let's see what else. You had shared this on social media. I saw Pop Culture in Australia. If you can't find them in the U.S., they do have those from their site, and you can order through their store, and they'll ship to the U.S.
Now, these prices that we're sharing here on screen are in Australian dollars, so knock off maybe about, I don't know, $5 or $6 or something. You've got the US price. But you've got a handy little converter up at the top. Just switch from EUD to USD, and you'll get the US prices. But, yeah, there's a ton of stuff. Again, I think as we mentioned, or you and I spoke about, a lot of the exclusives, there we go, there's Kit Fisto in stock, no Walgreens sticker, but there are no exclusives overseas. Mm-hmm. They're all widely available. So, I mean, for a long, long time, when I spent a couple of years in Nashville trying to get those Walgreens exclusives, particularly the Marvel ones, was beyond painful. I've still never seen them. If you're just banging your head against a brick wall and you want to get some of these, there's the Reyes you just mentioned, or the Snowtrooper, you can get them. And it's really not that much. You consider the amount of gas that you would probably spend and your time running around trying to get them. If you really, really want one exclusive Walgreens one, and it's particularly for exclusives, it's a great place to go.
Right. Yeah, I've shopped from them once before, and they're really good. I mean, you wait a little bit, but you know, if you're going to secure an item, then you know, if you can wait, then that's a decent route to take.
Exactly.
This had shown up. This list of pops had shown up from May the Funko Be With You's Twitter page. A list of about what looks like 18 possible pops coming for Rogue One. This is from a database.
Yep.
Somewhere. So.
This is very common for Funko. They don't give the names away. They did the same for The Force Awakens. You wouldn't get to see. It was just pop one, pop two, pop three, pop four. But you can see there's a couple of numbers missing there, which always says to me that they're reserved for exclusives or something. So, or variants or whatever it may be. But. Yeah, Rogue One's going to be a big movie. Big movie. There's certainly, I think after the success of The Force Awakens, and let's face it, isn't it still the biggest movie of all time?
It's
so
probably
something like that. I don't know. Yeah. It's selling me a few bucks.
Right.
No reason why Rogue One won't get such an investment too. So yeah, plenty of pops coming.
Yep. And see, one more list here to share. This one again was shared by May the Fun Co. Be With You's Twitter page. A couple exclusives that are coming to GameStop, which is Dagobah Yoda, which I don't recall seeing before. There's been a couple lists that have been floating out for a couple weeks now. I don't remember this one popping up, but we only have a Yoda with a lightsaber, and then there's a ghost version, you know, a spirit version of that figure with a lightsaber. You know, not technically all that accurate. But if they're making all new Yoda, I'm all for that.
Yeah, I think it probably could be, in my mind, I think the classic sitting on the log, you know, where you stick forward could be a perfect one. They've done a few pops like that before where there's kind of items underneath them. I mean, Yoda's small, so...
Right.
I like the Cozy droid, the COZ4. That's a great looking character, so that'll make an interesting looking pop. So.
Right, yeah, that one came out on a list. I think that was part of what had come out at Toy Fair, that droid, but that Endor Luke was on that list right under under Yoda, and I think that's the first time that's shown up on a list.
Cool.
So more pops sure for that. More pops for my pop wall. let's see, moving on to some Sideshow and General Giant and Lego news. General Giant Sideshow announced today they had previewed this before, but this is kind of an official glam shot of the Forlom sixth scale figure.
I'm glad you're a Forlom person as well. A lot of people argue that it's for LOM and stuff, and it's like,
yeah,
it's Forlom.
Yeah, I go Forlom. If it's LOM, he'd have, I don't know, would there be
dots or something? Yeah, exactly. It's one of these eternal redesigned Forlom for LOM.
Yeah.
Love the look of this guy. The look of this guy. So, yeah.
I think Metacom had done one before.
That's right. That's right. But so, just that little bit shorter, like an inch shorter from the 1/12 scale. But, yeah, I love the there's a little kind of backstory about how they used old parts for 3PO and other bits and pieces. And that's how they made them. Very cool.
Yep. So this will go on for pre-order next week, next Thursday, here in the U.S. So if you're looking to expand your Bounty Hunter 6th scale figures, you could be sure to jump on that pre-order. We'll be sure to post that link when it goes live. You know, it'll be shared on YakFace.com and Facebook, Twitter, so you'll be alerted when it's available. Let's see. General Giant, they had put up, I think on our last show, we had teased some silhouettes of some figures or some releases that were planned for their Premier Guild gift selection. They unveiled officially the full shots of the Admiral Ackbar mini bust, which looks pretty good.
It does, yeah. Really does.
There's also the... Oh, go ahead.
No, I was just going to say his little tendrils underneath his chin, those horribly wobbly turkey little pieces of skin. All the detail is there. Very good.
And then the Carbonite Han Solo Jumbo Kenner figure.
That looks good.
It's the coin. It's pretty awesome. Mm. That's the one I went with for the gift.
Yeah, very cool.
So if people don't know how that works, if you sign up for a Premier Guild membership, it's an $80 annual subscription, or, you know, basically it's like a club you enter, and you get one of these items free as part of that as part of that membership, and then you have the option to buy the others at a discount. So,
it's definitely a good deal. It works if you're a Gentle Giant fan or you're a Jumbo Kenner figure fan. It's the thing to do.
So then also in this was the classic bust of the Shadow Trooper.
Looking very good.
Mm-hmm.
Like that Imperial Crest at the foot. That's very nice. Indeed.
Right. And then finally the Ugnaught mini bus 2-pack, which has one of each Ugnaught and one holding 3PO's head, the other with 3PO's arm.
Nice.
Pretty cool.
It's pretty meta as well. I mean, these little guys are barely on screen and they're getting their own bust. So, yeah, if you're an Ugnaught fan, way to go.
Yeah. Really happy. Let's see, what else? I think also this week, I thought there was another bit of Gentle Giant news. I might not have put it in the show notes, but I'll talk about it here briefly. GameStop had launched on their site, you could go to yakface.com and take the link, but there are three new classic busts, similar to that Shadow Trooper that we had just talked about. There's the regular Stormtrooper, you know, the white armor. That's available now through GameStop.com. You could purchase it. They have that in stock. They also have a Boba Fett that is coming in October, I believe.
Oh, there we go.
Yep.
Oh, cool.
And then there's a TIE Fighter pilot that is coming in December. So
that's interesting to see the busts are kind of making a bit of a comeback, because for long enough, right. I mean, you know, I've been reporting on this stuff for ages and they just died off and mm-hmm. Now all of a sudden, boom, they're back.
So, yeah. So again, yeah. These are about $80 a piece. Like we had mentioned, they're more of the classic or traditional bust style for them. You know, they don't have the arms and.
Yep.
They're more bust like the initial launch of the busts were from Gentle Giant, but really nice. Only available through GameStop.
Cool.
What else? Lego. Lego had a. I didn't receive this announcement. Even though I am a Lego VIP person, Lego stores are going to have. Well, I saw this was shared over at Rebel Scum. They're going to have a event on the 30th, or what is that date? The 28th of April.
That's right.
A special Lego event where you have the option to purchase a, what's they're calling a Space Slug set.
Space Slug set, wow, okay. The double VA points, free first order Stormtrooper.
Right, that's the Finn one, I think. Is it the Finn one, or is it the...
I think it's the one with the pauldron.
Oh, yeah, that's sure right. The, yep.
Orange or white, I can't remember which one it is, but a free limited edition Escape the Space Slug set. Wow.
Right.
That's interesting.
So I wonder what if it's there? Like one of those little boxed sets similar to the convention exclusive ones.
Yep.
I think where you build a little... Build a little space slug and you get a little Millennium Falcon that you can build with it. I don't know. Yep.
I think it would have to be if you think about it in terms of, I mean, space slug's big.
Yeah.
So the Falcon's going to have to be tiny. So yeah, I think a little micro set or something.
Yep.
Entry. Little diorama piece or something on it. If it is, those things go for crazy money. So,
yeah. So that's coming up here in the next week or you know, next week. Yep. Disney Elite Discounts was something you had shared here.
Yes, courtesy of our friend Scott from Tulsa. Always the ever store reporting guy. You need to follow that guy if you want some discounts on Star Wars and other toys. But he shared this and I turned shared it on there. But Disney Elite Store figures, Disney Elite Series figures are on sale in the US for $19 online. So some of the ones they had on offer, they were Phasma, Kylo Ren and Poe Dameron. So not a fan of these myself, but $18.71, and there are some free shipping options with the Disney store. I know that. That's not bad.
Yeah, that's not bad at all. It's cheaper than a Black Series figure.
It is.
It is indeed. Yes, all metal. I was in a Disney store today, actually, and I didn't see that these were on sale, but I saw a lot of the stores have a decent stock of the reissues that we had talked about on our last show, the Grievous, yes, the Anakin, the Vader, characters like that. So they're definitely promoting these quite a bit through both online and in stores.
Yeah, like you have been in a couple of Disney stores recently as well, one in the UK as well, and there was plenty of Elite Series figures. There was real no major shortage.
Mm-hmm.
Of some of the ones asked, the one we're about to share in a minute, maybe not so.
Right. This one we had talked about again on our last show. I think the prototype Boba Fett has turned up in Italy. This was shared across the, I think it was the Elite Series Facebook page, but has been found in Milan, Italy already. So that's coming up as part of the May the 4th celebration sale, you know, Star Wars Day sale.
Yep. And I mean, it's essentially a repaint of the regular Boba Fett, I believe, with the cape. I don't see any major differences. There's no proper tweaks on it, but still looks great.
Yep.
That would be a nice standalone piece, I think.
Yep.
Yep. Cool.
I'll be getting that one.
Yes, I think I might have to get that myself. I think the fact it's all white compared to the other Boba Fett, which looked a little paintwork, could be a little mileage vary on a few of them. That
right.
The white one just stands out as something special. It's nice. I like it.
Let's see. More Disney stuff. There was a release today as far as, I didn't see an official announcement, but official images did start popping up for the Force Awakens Zoom Zoom little plushy gerbils.
Thingies. Gerbils. I like the name gerbils. I like that too.
Yeah.
So what are these? Are these jumbo ones? In the
yeah, they have big ones. Like they're like pillow size.
Oh my goodness.
So there's like a large, which Kylo Ren and BB-8 in that image we're looking at there. Those are the biggest ones. And then there's like a medium size, which has Phasma. Or is that Phasma or is that a regular stormtrooper? I can't tell.
It looks a little chromey. So, yeah. But it could be white. But
so that's kind of a medium size. And then there's the mini regular size ones. Yeah. But yeah, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, nine in the Force Awakens series. So it's kind of interesting. You get two Reys, one with her scavenger gear on, one without. Then you get two Finns, one with his resistance jacket and one in his stormtrooper gear. Then you get a Kylo Ren, a stormtrooper, regular stormtrooper, Phasma, Poe, and a BB-8. So.
Nice. Will the Yak Face household be buying some more of these?
Yep. We'll be getting all. Well, I will be getting all of the small ones. We'll see if the
for the small
that BB-8, the biggest, you know, the pillow size ones might turn up over here. My kids love BB-8, so I might end up stealing it from them, but it might end up showing up in the house anyway. What else? Walgreens Star Wars clearances. Again, this was something that was shared from Scott from Tulsa. I saw that popped across my Twitter feed today or this evening. A lot of older merchandise that's been at Walgreens has gone on some deep clearances. There's some Hot Wheels sets that was originally $10. You can buy them for like $2.50 or $1.50. I don't know. Some other puzzles.
$2.50.
Yeah, why not? So,
no. Boba Fett coin bank was $4.50, now $1.49. I think again that word we always use, mileage may vary. In all the Walgreens I ever visited, the clearance sections were wildly different. So I think it was the manager's discretion. But love that artwork, the unleashed artwork there on that collectible tin. So it was $15 now $5. So yeah, you might not see it in your Walgreens, but check around, drive around, and. Of course, you could always drive to Tulsa where everything is low cost.
Good deal there. Let's see. Moving on to a couple other things here. The Force Awakens poster, the actual theatrical poster, not the teaser. A couple months ago, it was available through the Disney Movie Rewards program where if you buy so many Disney titles, you get points and you're able to redeem them for freebies essentially on the Disney Movie Rewards site. The Force Awakens poster has shown up on there again. It costs 1,000 points.
Yep.
So it's sad that this is the only way that you can get any of the theatrical posters.
I'll give it time. I'm sure there'll be, I'm sure on eBay there's plenty of bootlegs, but I'm sure in time they'll make this more widely available. It's too popular a film. But yeah, it's a little annoying why they can't do that, but I'm sure maybe movieposters.com or posters.com, I'm sure I'll get them.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yep. So I'm waiting for the Rogue One to poster to show up on there, because that's going to be the next one that's going to be available.
That would be nice indeed.
Let's see. Moving on to TV, movie, book, and game news. StarWars.com had shared an article earlier this week regarding elite stormtroopers are coming to the Marvel Comics series, starting with issue number 21. So we're going to get... It's almost like they're doing the Clone Wars kind of treatment to some of these.
Yeah, I agree.
And it's cool. I mean, there were a lot of different types of stormtroopers in some of the older Marvel series that are quote-unquote legends now. Now we get to see some of these are actually, again, these are concept drawings, so it's not
true.
It's not what we're going to see in the final comic, but I wouldn't doubt that the troopers being too far off from this.
Yep. So. Oh, if Hasbro could just make some of these. I mean, they have in the past. We've seen the Force Unleashed have the jump troopers, and Force 2 had various troopers as well. And they were good. They were great way back in the days when we got articulated stuff at 3.75. But these one or two of these just even released in the main line, I think a lot of people would just lose it. And it's too far for them to, you know, add on a backpack, tweak a little bit of a head or, you know, helmet, and off you go. But they look fantastic.
Yeah, do a box set or something.
Exactly. That would just, oh, yes.
Entertainment Earth exclusive box set. You know, they had done that type of stuff before with was that Battlefront, or was that
Battlefront 2, I think
Republic Commando, something like that.
Commando, they did a set too, that's right, but there was a Battlefront 2 one as well, or Battlefront 1 and 2. Sadly, a lot of the Entertainment Earth exclusives these days don't seem to be quite as cool as that. Hasbro tend to keep this stuff more exclusive, right. But that would be nice.
Since we're getting new troopers, new style of stormtroopers showing up in Rogue One, it's not too surprising that they're going to try to dip their toe into different types of troopers for this other storyline.
Yeah, why not?
This comic
why
series, not? So pretty cool.
Yep.
Let's see. Well, I guess it was last week. I was a guest on the Toy Run podcast, which was put on by Crisby from Jedi Business and Jake from Forlom to Zuckus. They interviewed me for a little segment on their show, their newest show. It's I think this was episode 6. So it was fun talking Star Wars, and it wasn't so much about current news. It was more like the state of collecting kind of deal, where my thoughts on 5POA versus articulated figures, and you know, where I thought the line was going and stuff. It was a great time. So I encourage everyone to go over there and give that a download. There's, you know, iTunes, you could download it through their site, and different YouTube channel that you can watch it or listen. So it's good. It was a fun time.
No, I'll definitely be listening to that. Like it.
What else? I think that was pretty much it for the major relevant news for the week. A few reviews and new acquisitions for either of us this week. Did you have anything?
There will be a bunch of stuff, about 5 or 6 reviews and little store reports and Comic-Con reviews of little things that we're over here going up shortly in the next day or two. So no, nothing as yet, but they're coming very soon.
Nice. I received my Premier Guild Emperor Palpatine mini bust. That was I did a quick photo gallery and basic review of it. It's not going to win any awards for me as far as the best bust they've ever done. You know, sculpt and paint are good. It's got a nice texture to the fake robes, you know, they're it's obviously a sculpted material. It's not actually cloth. So the likeness is pretty decent, but there's some other negatives about it as well.
Yep. I mean, look, it's, you know, busts, it's a tough thing. Some really nail it, some don't, but
yeah, like they nail their troopers. It's the human likenesses that sometimes don't quite hit the mark.
Exactly.
You know, this is supposed to represent an episode 5 version of the Emperor, which was only in hologram form. So
Yep. Well, this is the perfect thing, and that's the reason why toy guides are really useful that you've done. You can, if you really want to get this thing, and I mean, that does look pretty good.
There's
plenty of people that are palpable, man. So, I mean, it's, go and have a look at all the photographs. And, you know, this is a limited edition thing. It's not widely available, but it's, at least you get to see every angle and you can decide if you're going to get it. But I like it. It's actually not bad at all. It's not bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not the most exciting character, as he really to do. It's hard.
It's the third Palpatine bust they've done. You know, whether it's, if you count Sidious as Palpatine and in that line, I have the Sidious one right here. Actually, let me pop this over. This was my favorite version of Sidious they had done. I mean, the likeness is. It's really good in that figure. And the pose just overall is a lot more dynamic than this newest one. And then there's the regular Emperor from Return of the Jedi, which is, again, it's a decent one. The likeness is okay. It's kind of the middle of the two.
Is there no electric kind of add-ons there for the shocking?
No electricity for this one. But
shame.
Again, that's a lot of Palpatine busts I have now.
I'm sure Steve and Ann at one point talked about we just talked about rumors, but I mean, the potential is there to have a Palpatine Black Series re-release with electric hands, just a different face sculpt. That'd be perfect.
Yeah.
I thought Hasbro would have cashed in on that right away, but maybe we'll get it further down the line. Anyway.
Right. Let's see, new acquisitions and purchases. I know you said you're waiting for a few things.
Sure. It's on the way from Dark Side Toys, the Ahsoka boxed versions of them, the Ahsoka, Kanan, and Luke, that revision wave, which is so typical of Hasbro. They've delivered the revision wave before the regular wave. What a strange company they are. And the Marvel Legends Captain America Civil War figures, which come out here next week. I cannot wait to see that movie. So
I know.
So excited. What about you?
Let's see. I had a few things mentioned. I found the Pops since our last show, the four Walgreens Pops, which are, again, on my tower of Pops at work. I grabbed a few mini busts that I was missing for my collection of prototype Boba Fett merchandise. I have them right here, actually. The prototype Boba Fett mini bust that was exclusive. It was the 2015 convention exclusive. A very cool pose for that mini bust. So
that's nice.
I grabbed that. And then I also managed to score the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive one from 2009, which is the more concept.
Beautiful. Yeah, concept I love that version. One.
So, and I got great deals on both these. Two different sellers on eBay paid regular retail price for this concept one. Which was kind of surprising to me, considering it's Boba Fett and it's a convention exclusive. You know, it was $80. So,
wow. I think it just shows you, if you play the long game, these things work. I mean, I've seen a lot of convention exclusives 2 years down the line where people are like, I'm sick of this thing, and trying to get the money back, and it's not as popular. So you can pick up a bargain. And that bust alone, I remember seeing going for like 150, 160, because I wanted, I was going to get that 1.2. So 80 bucks is a bargain. Well done.
Yeah, the other one, the auctions are all over the place on eBay for the for last year's convention exclusive one. You know, it could go for $300. I've seen, I didn't even pay half that. It was like 120, you know, and that's with shipping. So
and pretty good deal on that. Of course they could, yeah.
So
well, we got to park. I think you've done over the years what a lot of people probably need to do, and that is hone in on your focus. And, you know, Yoda's a core thing for you, Protate Fett's a thing for you. You know, unfortunately, Funko Pop is there. Another new addiction, but, you know, hey, we all have a sick collecting in this podcast, so, you know, whatever. So,
yep.
Very good.
And then let's see what else I picked up. I received my case of 6-inch figures that has Kanan, Luke, and Ahsoka, so I have those secure now. And from what it sounds like, Jedi Temple Archives reported today, I think, that that's pretty much the last wave that's going to show up in this packaging. So until Force Friday launches, we won't get any of those figures that we've been seen that we've been shown before, like the Leia, the Sabine. Those characters, those will all be in the new packaging. So, makes sense, I guess.
Yeah, again, it's just there's so many changes in this line packaging wise. I know a lot of people who've just invested in protected cases for the Black Series 6-inch, and at least the more modern blue line, not the orange line, the blue line of them. And these black and red figures still fit in the box, but if they change it dramatically, then knows. So
yeah,
I hope they keep it the same.
Yeah, I would imagine they would keep the same basic footprint.
I hope so. I hope so. That seems to work.
Yep. I think with that wraps up this week's show. A shorter show, but full of full of good information, I think. We'll be back next week, I believe, with another new episode. Hopefully more good news will come out in the meantime. So, until then, thanks for everyone for watching and sharing and commenting, and we'll see you in the toy aisle.
See ya.